Craft beers are expensive, you know. You make a killing. Woo! Woo, who's this little feller? Oh my gosh!
Winter's a good time to break out the old fishing rod, isn't it?
Oh, it sure is. I like to break out my rod as much as I can during the winter. Alright, survivors, welcome back to Stardew Valley. It is now Monday the 1st of winter. The first day of winter! I'm so excited to go— oh, wait a second. Ew! Ew, what's this long slippery thing in the bed with me? Hold on a sec, let me pull this thing out. I got it. Got it! Oh, it's just an eel. Okay. Just a long, slippery little fish is all. No big deal. Let's throw this in the fridge. That is where long, slippery little fish belong. Along with the algae soup and the oil, of course, so we can turn you into some nice, tasty meals. What'd you think it was? Get your mind out of the gutter. It's just a fish. Anyway, welcome back to Stardew Valley. Here with yours truly, level 17 farm boy. Am I reading that right? That's a farm boy. Wow. Upgrade Punchwood up from a sod buster, right? Ooh, Haley's going to be so happy because I think that's her pet name for Punchwood here, right? Now it's official. Now he is an official farm boy. Expect a few inches of snow tomorrow. Oh, that's going to be awesome. I can't wait to see the snow. Spirits are very displeased today. No big deal. And we have a new episode of Living Off the Land with Farmer Green Beans. Winter, a time when all the world goes quiet. Now's a great time to do some mining, fishing, and gathering. Upgrade your tools in preparation for a productive spring, or get your local carpenter to build something on your farm. Stock up on resources, upgrade, and prepare for the next year. That is great advice, Farmer Green Beans. Thank you for that. We will be doing that and much more, I am sure, considering the fact that we can't do any farming, really, during the winter because everything, all the crops are dead. But first things first, before we head outside and check out the winter, let's move some of the furniture around. That is the giant pretzel that Leah gave us. Let's put the ring-a-ding-ding over here, and we're going to put this crystally thing down there. Perfect! We've got all this space. We really need to kind of spread our wings, as it were. All right, you ready to get outside and check the winter? Oh, so exciting! Gonzo, you're in charge. I'll see you later. Oh, Shane! A wild Shane has appeared on the porch. Hey. Hey, back. Oh, man, it's good to see you up and about. I didn't think you'd be out of the hospital so soon. Oh, man. How do I say this? I'm really sorry about what happened at the cliffs. That was embarrassing. Don't mention it, Shane. I'm just happy you're alive. What the? All right, we have three options here. So I don't know if you guys recall, but yesterday, Shane went on a bit of a bender. He was feeling a little hopeless and depressed. And he went to a cliffside, had a bunch of beers, and he had some bad thoughts. But we brought him to the hospital. And now he's here to apologize for his episode yesterday. So let's see what we got. We've got, I'm glad I was there to help. You needed a serious wake-up call, young man. And I'm just happy you're still here. Well, frankly, all three of these do apply. However, I think we should let him down easy. He's fragile right now. So let's just pick this one right here. I'm just happy you're still here, Shane. Wow, it was that serious, huh? I can hardly remember. Which doesn't surprise me, Shane. There were 472 beer cans near you. Empty, that is. I've decided I want to see a therapist. Harvey got me in touch with a colleague of his. Anyway, I just wanted to thank you for taking care of me, and I want you to know that I'm going to take things a little more seriously from now on. I don't want to be a burden on anyone. Shane, admitting you have a problem is the first step, man. Therapy sounds great, and listen, we're here for you. Anytime you want to talk, you come by. Shane? Oh. He's gone. He's very embarrassed. He just bolted. Okay. Yeah. Oh, hi, Wilson. Hi. Yeah, come on down here. It's winter. Come here, boy. Isn't it awesome? Guys, check this out. Don't worry. We'll talk more about Shane, and we'll catch up with him later. It's very serious business. But right now, we have winter. This is awesome. All the trees are dead, though. All the crops are gone, as I said, except for these two little pieces of corn. Guys, how do you do it? How do you stay so young? You guys survive through summer. Summer and fall, right? So, can I save you? No, I can't. I killed you. Oh my gosh, I just killed it. Oh, I was hoping to maybe get some seeds. I don't know what I was thinking. I just killed him. Oh well. Anyway, let's check the mail here. We got some actual mail in the mailbox. It's from Robin. Dear Punchwood, here is an old recipe that my grandma passed down to me. Enjoy! Pumpkin soup! Awesome! Well, we have pumpkin, so we can make that. Oh, we have another one. And this is from Demetrius.
Dear Punchwood, I was conducting a field study the other day, and I found this specimen. I hope you find it as interesting as I did.
And that is amethyst. Okay, thanks, Demetrius. Hey, listen, I already have some, but if it's free, it's for me. In fact, let's chuck that in here. Well, let's sell it, because we have extras anyway. So, we got some oil here, we got some iron, and it just feels so weird. I don't have any farming to do. I don't know what to do with myself. I guess, I gotta grab that. So, let's go, let's let the chickens. We can't let them out. There's nothing to do out here. They won't want to come out because it's cold. So, and there's no more food. Look at all the grass is dead. Fortunately, our silo is full. Yeah, pretty much full. Well, let's go in and check on that heater. Oh, it's working! It's actually working! Ooh, that feels good, girls! Dilly, you like it? Dilly likes it. Alright, I'm gonna grab your eggs. How about you? Who are you? Dally. And you must be Dottie. Alright, excellent. Well, enjoy your heater. It's nice and warm in here. Oh, right. I gotta feed you guys. Throw some more food over here. This should get you through the winter. Alright, girls. Have a good day indoors. I don't think they'll come out even if I open the door, so I'm not gonna bother. Alright, let's get some mayo going. No. I don't want to eat a raw egg. I'm going to make some mayonnaise. We need to make money during the winter since we're not going to be crops to sell. So, let's make sure we get some oil going. So, I guess this is what I do in the winter. Just my artisan goods. I got a lot of stock left over for all this. All the berries, got lots of corn for oil. So, that should be pretty awesome. Well, I guess that's it. Let's hop on old Bud here and let's get to town. I want to go see what the town looks like. I want to do some foraging. There is a winter forage bundle that we need to complete. And, oh, wormies. Wormies. You stomped all over them, Bud. Fortunately, they're still alive. Let me see what's down there. Oh, book. Another book. We'll have to go to the library and read these because I think I found a few others too. So, yeah, let's look for some winter forage. Sometimes we get some up here. Oh, there's one. Oh, and worms. Wormies up here too. But this we already have, a crystal fruit, don't we? In fact, let me just check that bundle. I forget where it is. Winter foraging bundle, here it is. Yeah, we need a snow yam and a crocus. We already have the winter root and the crystal fruit. So only two more to go. And let's check on the wormies. Prehistoric nose. Yeah, I already have one of those. 12 o'clock noon. Oh, and it's Sam. Where are you headed, Sam? What are you doing on a day like today? Don't you have school? Everyone's indoors during the winter, so I can play guitar as loud as I want. I guess you don't go to school. It must be dumb at school. Hey, Marnie! Marnie, how goes it? Animals are so innocent, so sweet. And if I don't look after them, who will? I know that, but winter's here! You have nothing to say about winter? I just hope my chickens aren't too upset when I take their eggs. That's part of their job, but I don't think they care too much. Oh, Leah. Leah's going into Piers. We're going to head in there in a second, but first let me just check the calendar here. So Monday, the 1st of winter, year one, of course. We've got nothing for the next 2 days, but Linus's birthday on Wednesday. All right. Well, we'll have to remember that. And we have a help wanted sign here from M. Rasmodius Wizard. Local wizard in search of a fresh earth crystal. 150 gold on delivery, and I will be pleased. It's M. Rasmodius. All right, well, we can do that. We have earth crystals back at home. And in fact, today, guys, I want to go see the wizard to give him the void essence. So we'll stop off and get the earth crystal for him, too. And now I want to say hi to Leah. Hello, Leah. I haven't talked to her in so long. I love the way everything looks when it's covered with fresh snow. I do, too. That makes two of us. Oh, what does it mean? What can I give her? I don't think she appreciates, like, gemstones. She might like the blueberry jelly. But I do need to make money this winter. Yeah, sorry. I have nothing for you today. I'm gonna go sell my jelly to Pierre. Oh, he doesn't buy the oil. Oh, you jerk. Why not? Oh, he's got some. All right, fine. I'll go sell it on the street corner. I'll be your competition. Here, take my blueberry jelly at the very least. All right, well, what do you sell yours for? 200? Wow. You'll buy the crystal fruit. I already have a couple of these, so I'm just going to sell it. All right, well, see ya. Oh, he does have oil. Look at all that oil. My gosh, tons of it. All right, well, let's, what do we do? Just, I don't know what to do with myself. Oh, look at this. I didn't even notice the, all the Christmas lights. Oh, this looks fantastic. Oh, I love it. You know what? Let's go say hi to Harvey. Harvey did a good job with Shane. Harvey! I'm not good enough friends with Harvey. I'm not good enough friends to enter his bedroom. All right. Well, people might talk if I enter his bedroom anyway, so probably not a bad thing. All right, there's all the ladies. Oh, Christmas tree! Whoa, Evelyn, did you do this? It's gorgeous!
Be careful you don't slip on the ice, dear.
Okay, I'll try not to. I have my winter boots on. Check them out. Anyway, if you did this, you did a great job decorating. I love it so much. Okay. Well, let's go see the wizard. We're off to see the wizard, ladies! Oh, there's Vindog playing in the snow. All right, I'm going to sell the oil to see what it's worth and the prehistoric hand axe. I'm pretty sure I have one of these. And I've given it to Gunther already. And the amethyst, and I just sell it. Like I said, I need to make money this winter. We can't do it with crops. So I'm going to have to sell all that stuff. And I need an earth crystal, right? For M. Rasmodeus Wizard. There we go. And I'll grab some mayonnaise while I'm here. And maybe we'll give one to the wizard. And then we'll sell the rest. All right, here we go. Where's my path? I can't tell where the path is because all that grass is gone. Oh, we should get some hardwood while we're down here too. And we should do some winter fishing too. I'm just curious. Oh, what's this? Oh, it looks like holly. It's holly. It is holly, guys. The leaves and bright red berries make a popular winter decoration, but you don't want to eat it. Trust me. It'll make you sick, if not kill you. All right, well, that doesn't go in the winter bundle, which is weird, huh? All right, anyway, bud, you stay here. Don't get too close to this tower. This guy's weird. Hello, M. Rasmodeus. How are you, buddy? Ah, yes. I have seen many things about your future, young Punchwood. Great, but you've never told me anything. If I were to tell you, there could be grave consequences. Right. That's what you tell me every time. Anyway, I got some stuff here for you, pal. You've been after an earth gem. Ah, the item I requested. Dude, we got two. Yeah, I can go up into his bedroom, I think, now. Your work was satisfactory. Here is your compensation. Thanks. 150 gold. And wait a minute, we're not done here. I understand you like void acids. Here you go. Ah, this is imbued with potent arcane energies. It's very useful for my studies. Thank you. You're welcome. Why do you talk like that? It's funny. It's funny. Funky. And now I think I have access to... What are you doing? I only allow those I trust to enter there. But I got two hearts with you, man. How many hearts do I need? Whatever. I don't remember seeing this before. What is this? This looks new. All right, well, I guess I can't do anything here with the two hearts. Fine. Goodbye. Man, it's dark already. All right, guys, we're in the secret wood. I'm grabbing some hardwood here. We have holly, and we have worms to boot. Jackpot in here. Awesome. All right, let's grab these little wormies. What do we got? Oh, it's a snow yam. Ooh, we need that for the bundle. That's one of the winter harvests. Is that a... Oh, it is. There's a slime back there. You stuck, buddy? Yeah, let me help you out. It's one way out. All right, anything else around here that I need to see? I wonder if I fish in the secret wood, what I get in here. Let's try fishing here. I think there is a special fish in the secret wood. I'm not sure if I can actually catch it now or what, but... Oh, you know what? We need a sturgeon. We can catch a sturgeon in the winter up at the lake. I'm not sure. Oh my gosh, this thing's dead. I hooked a dead fish. It doesn't want to move. Yeah, I think we can catch a sturgeon up at the lake during the winter. And we need that for the bundle. And I think we complete the lake bundle, in fact. These fish don't even move. They're so cold because of the winter. It's all carp. Let me see. How many is that? All right, put it away. That is four carp. Four Magikarp from the Magic Woods. All right, five carp, that's good enough. And man, we are running low on bait. I don't have much bug meat either. But we did get a recipe for a worm box or container or something, didn't we? So we're gonna have to go check that out. I think it requires hardwood. And I almost forgot these secret hardwoods down here. Let's snatch them up. All right, guys, we're back at the Punchwood Farmstead. We're gonna put Bud back. There you go, Bud, enjoy your hay. And we're gonna sell a few of these things here. We got all the mayonnaise, we got five Magikarps, And I'm thinking I'm going to sell all of this holly, too. I think I'll save the golden star belly just because. I'm going to chuck the newspaper in there. And I think that's it for now. Oh my gosh, what is this? Pale ale! We got pale ale! We brewed our first beer! Looks delicious, and if I recall correctly, Pam wants a pale ale. And she's been waiting for a really long time. So guess what we're gonna do? We're gonna give it to her. The pale ale, that is. But not tonight, because I gotta get to bed. We'll give it to her tomorrow. All right, I'm gonna hit the sack. Good night, Wilson. We'll see you in the morning. Okay, nothing long and slippery in my pockets, right? Okay, good. Let's go to sleep for the night. And here endeth the firsteth of winter, year oneth. I love the winter already, and I can't wait to see the snow in the morning. And we made almost 1,800 gold, not too shabby for a day of no farming. All right, so that's it for now, guys. We'll see you. Actually, let's continue. I think we can squeeze in a little bit more. There's not much going on in the winter, so I think we can get another day in. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, guys, let's continue with another day, shall we? It is now Tuesday, the second day of winter, 6 o'clock in the morning, and just so you know, I already have about 25 minutes of footage, believe it or not, the first day was that much content. I didn't even realize, but I'm going to have to get creative and cut it up a little bit to try to get a good 25-minute episode. Anyway, I'll take care of that. Don't worry about a thing. And it looks like we're going to have some snow tomorrow. And it should be snowing today, right? I don't see it. Oops, no. Change the channel. I don't see it out the window. It looks sunny. Spirits are very happy today. Awesome! Yeah, I can't tell. I think it's white out. Let's go see the snow. Oh my gosh, it is practically white out. Wilson, come down here, buddy. Look at the snow. Oh, I love it. This is so great. How's it on the frame rate? Yeah, it seems okay. All right, let's have some algae for breakfast. All right, let me just get organized here, guys. I've got a bunch of stuffs to do, and then we're gonna roll out. But first, let's check the mail. You guys wanna see who sent us a letter, right? Let's see. Oh, it's Willie, the fisherman.
Hey, I've got a little challenge for you. Catch me a squid. You can fish them from the ocean at night. They only show up in the winter, though, Willie.
Awesome. All right, that's a non-timed quest, too. Catch a squid. Great, so we have all the time. Well, we only have winter to do that. So, in fact, I think today we're actually going to do some fishing because I do want to catch a sturgeon, and I would like to go down to the beach and try for this this squid as well. We have to deliver a pale ale to Pam, right? So we'll go try to track her down if we can, and I think I'm gonna stuff the just put the cloth in here for now with the other crafting materials. Oh, one other thing I wanted to do is move all the food products that we cook with into the house. And you know, you can make some kind of fishy stews with some of these periwinkles and things. So yeah, just give me a minute here, guys. I'm gonna just get prepared for the day, and then we'll head out and go do something fun. All right, guys, it's now almost 10:30 in the morning, and I want to show you my refrigerator. Look at all the goodies in there now. So most of my vegetables and even some seafoods have been stuffed in here, and yet we have almost a whole row left. So, yeah, I'm glad I bought the super deluxe size of refrigerator model. Spared no expense, but that gives us access now to more of these recipes by having those foods inside the refrigerator. Okay, anyway, let's go back out into the snow. And my gosh, I wish I had a coat. Look at poor Punchwood here in his coveralls. He's still wearing his farming overalls. He needs a jacket. I wasn't eyeballing you. I know you have fur. I wouldn't make a coat out of you. Boy, did he run. Did you see that? He wanted none of that. Anyway, let's go ahead and make some trap bobbers. I'm gonna make two of these. I hear these are the best. So I think we're ready to go. All right, yeah, let's rock and roll. I've got everything I need. All right, here we are at town. We have a couple stops to make. Oh, it's Abby and Robin. Hi, Robin. Hey, that refrigerator's fantastic. Thanks for hooking me up. Hey, if you need any materials or blueprints, my shop is the place you're looking for. Oh, I know. I've been there several times. Wait, Abigail, hi. It's so cold. I wish I had a hot cup of cocoa to share. Oh, yeah. Hey, I have a new refrigerator and a new kitchen. I don't have any cocoa, though. So, well, all right. Bye. Yeah, we're going to have to work on that. If I can get a cup of hot cocoa for her, that'd be awesome. I just want to go and say hi to the doc. Oh, Evelyn. Evelyn's here. Hi, Evelyn. You okay?
Aren't you cold? You should wear a thicker jacket, my dear.
I was just thinking the same thing this morning when I came out of the house. It was freezing. Maybe I can borrow one of George's. I don't have one.
This weather isn't good for my joints.
Well, I hope you're okay. Maybe just a regular checkup. All right, I'm going to go see Doc Harvey if he's in. Oh, there he is. He's in his little office over here. I want to just thank him. Hey, Doc, thanks for helping out with Shane. You did a great job.
Feel free to stop by my office if you're ever feeling ill.
Yeah, I will. I just wanted to thank you for taking care of Shane for us.
You're young, though. You'll probably stay healthy without trying.
Yeah, I guess so. All right, see you, Doc. Thanks. Don't they sell stuff here? Energy tonic. Wow, 500 energy, 200 health for 1,000 gold? That's crazy. And then a muscle remedy here, which is the same price, but not even close to the same effect, is it? No, not at all. All right, anyway, I'm out of here. Bye! Doc must be getting some kind of kickback for that muscle remedy. Overcharging for sure. All right, anyway, what is it? 12:30. What are we doing? Let's go. I'm going to go to the lake. I'm going to go up to the lake. We're going to do some fishing. But first, I want to drop off this wintery forage thing I have. Goes down here in the crafts room. It is a snowy yam. All we need now is a crocus and construction materials, and we can get the bridge repaired. Ooh, I can do that. I just have to get the wood. I have the stone and the hardwood. I just need regular wood. Okay, well, we'll do some chopping soon. See ya, little buddies. All right, now let's get to the lake and do some ice fishing for the sturgeon. Oh, what a white bunny wabbit. And a squirrel. And some worms. All right, I'm going to get some worms here. Now, I would like to make... Oh, snowy yam. Cool. I would like to make the worm bin. Right, there's a worm bin that we can make. And that'll give us worm bait. Oh, there goes Linus. Linus, come over here. I'm fishing. And we can use worms for bait instead of bug bait, because I am almost out of bug bait. So we need a sturgeon. Sturgeon is going to be pretty hard to catch, I think. But we can catch them between 6 o'clock and 7 p.m. in the lake during the winter, but they're very hard. Oh, this is definitely not a sturgeon. Come on, man. You're wasting my trap bobber. What is that? It's a chub. Drat. Ooh, max cast. Woo! And it's a perch. Hey! Have I caught a perch before? I'm not sure. I'll have to check my my log, my fishing log. Whoa. Where you going, fella? Whoa. No. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, no. I have a trap bobber. Ah. I will trap you in my trap bobber. You're trapped. You can go nowhere. Ooh. Got him. It's a sturgeon. That's a sturgeon. My first sturgeon. My only sturgeon. It's an ancient bottom feeder with a dwindling population. Females can live up to 150 years, and you're mine, and I'm keeping you, and you're not going back in the water. 150 years. Wow. Oh, I feel terrible now. I kind of feel bad about this sturgeon, considering it's an endangered species. And I didn't throw it back, but you know what? Too bad. I have a lakefish bundle to complete. And a little man in a balloon to please, so I can get some kind of a reward. Let's see what it is. It's a dress spinner. The metal tab and colorful streamers create an enticing spectacle for fish. Increases the bite rate. Yeah, this doesn't matter. I don't need to increase my bite rate. All right. And last fish we need to get the boulder removed for the ultimate reward here is the sandfish, which we cannot catch until we open up the desert, I think. All right. Enjoy that sturgeon. It's an endangered species, you know. The females live to 150 years old. It's older than humans. I hope it's worth it. All right, let's stop off at the Stardrop Saloon and see if Pam's here. Oh, there she is. Pam, right in her spot. Hey, everybody. How's it going? I love the snow. Do you guys love winter? Awesome. Oh, Shane. Shane, you're here. What are you doing in the bar, man? I thought you were going to get serious about this problem. What you got there? Is that an apple juice?
Life isn't so bad. At least I have frozen pizza and eggs.
Yeah, that's the spirit. All right, enjoy your apple juice. I'm glad you're drinking apple juice. Oh, hi, Willie. I'm gonna catch that squid tonight, my friend. Oh gosh, what time is it anyway?
A true angler has respect for the water. Don't you forget that.
Oh, I would never forget that. I totally respect the water. I would not want to fall in. It's cold, especially during winter. Anyway, Gus, I gotta talk to you. How much for a pale ale before I give this one away for free? Oh, right, I gotta stand over here. It's all business with this guy. Okay, yeah, how much for a pale ale? How much? Nothing? Nothing? Come on, dude. I brewed it. It's a craft brew. It's worth hundreds. Fine. Well, then tell you what, I will give it to Pam. Hi, Pam.
Hey, Gus, give me another round.
No, wait, Pam, stop. No, Gus, don't do it. Don't you dare do it. I have a free beer for you. Here's your pale ale. I know it's been like months, but beggars can't be choosy, Pam.
Give me that. Ah, that's the stuff. It's real nice and hoppy. Notes of citrus and pine, but with a robust body to keep it grounded. Thanks, kid. This means a lot to me. I knew I could count on you.
Pam, you really know your beers. Well, I'm glad that you enjoyed that, because I enjoyed brewing it. I'll make some more for you.
Hey, Gus, give me another round.
Oh my, okay, I gotta go. Goodbye. Hey, Leah! Man, it's been a long time. It gets pretty cold in my little cabin. Maybe I can come by and warm it up with some... Oh, never mind. I just snuggle up under a huge blanket and I'm okay. Oh, of course you're okay without me in warming it. Okay, anyway. Hey, Leah, for old time's sake, it's the horseradish jam. It's our jam, girl. You look radishing tonight. Anyway, I gotta catch a fish. I'll see ya. Goodbye. Bye, everybody. All right, let's go catch this darn fish. In fact, let's just use the totem right now. I'm not wasting any time. How do we do this? Yep. See ya, bud. Oh, hi, Clint. Bye, Clint. It's gonna bring me right to the ocean. Oh, it did. All right, you know what? I probably could have just taken a ride on Bud. It was pretty close. Oh, well. All right, anyway. Let's, he'll find his way back home, by the way. Let's grab these worms. You want to grab all these shellfish because you can use them to make certain fishy stews that help you for fishing. They give you bonuses. And 350 gold. Oh, wow, that's right. She paid me for it. I completely forgot. That did have a price tag on it. Oh, I'm so happy. Good. Because it costs a lot to brew that. Craft beers are expensive, you know. You make a killing. Woo! Woo, who's this little feller? Oh my gosh! Still got him. Oh, I almost lost him. It's a tough one. I wonder if this is a squiddy. Could be a pufferfish. Have I caught a pufferfish? I haven't caught a pufferfish. Oh, I got you! It's a squid! I caught a sturgeon and a squid today! 12-incher! Woo, let's check him out. It's a deep sea creature. Really? Why did I catch him on a beach? That can grow to enormous size. He's awesome. All right, let's try for one more and then we'll run this one over to Willie. That was a pretty tough catch. I got lucky there at the end. All right, let's catch another squiddy. If I catch another one, I'll bring him home and make some calamari. I've got you now. Ah, herring. Just a red herring or blue herring. Okay, this is another squid, I bet.
Oh, a treasure! No way!
Oh, come on, squiddy, come down! Yeah. Good little fish. Good fish. Now we gotta catch you. Whoop. As long as he doesn't go back down to the bottom. He does love to go down to the bottom. See? He does. Why is my fishing bar seems really small right now? Gotcha. Yes! Squid number two! World record, 28 inches! And... I thought the spirits were, like, very happy today. Those little jerks. All right, now I gotta walk back in this cold, and I don't even have a coat. Well, hopefully Bud's still around. Bud! Buddy! There's Bud! All right, let's get in here before they close. It's 10:40. Hey, Willie, you're not gonna believe what I just got you. Let's give him the non-star belly squid. Told you I'd catch a squid, Willie!
Hey, you did it! Not bad! Not bad at all! I'm impressed! Winter's a good time to break out the old fishing rod, isn't it?
Oh, it sure is! I like to break out my rod as much as I can during the winter. Alright, I'll see you later then.
I need a little warm-up to be ready for another cold night on the ocean.
Yeah, I bet it gets cold out there. Oh, you still want to talk, huh? Oh, hi, Shane! I was having a conversation with Willie. Talking about my rod. Hold on a sec! No, Willie, I know, you already said that! Bye! Shane, wait! How you feeling? You're okay, right? Who's not talking to me? All right. Well, at least he's sober. All right, good night, Willie. I'm glad you got your squiddy. I'm going to bring mine home now. And we're back. And hot diggity dog, that was a good day, wasn't it? We caught a squid. We caught a sturgeon. Yeah, what a day. And it is getting late, but I need to sell some stuff. So let's sell the mayonnaise, and we'll sell these fish. Some of them, anyway. And you know, I'm going to sell that oil. See, I don't need that much oil. Oh, wow, a golden starbelly mayonnaise. Chuck it. Yeah, all right, that's good enough. I'm going to save those other fish. Oh, right, 800 gold. 800 gold? Oh, man, I need to pay closer attention to what these people are paying for these missions. It's pretty good money. And yeah, I'm going to hang on to some of these other fish. I am going to have to make like a fish barrel because I have a lot of them. All right, how about that calamari? Oh, I need a wheat flour. Okay, no calamari today, I'm afraid. That's okay. It's too late for calamari. Give me an upset stomach in the night. Good night, Wilson. Good to see you. Good night, LG Futton. Good night, Gonzo in the kitchen. And now, my friends, it is time to end this episode for realies. Let's check to see what we made as far as cashish goes. 1,241 is not terrible. And here endeth the secondeth of winter, year oneth. Hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.